Welcome back, everyone. This is track three. The room is quite full. What, did Nickelback not go as planned? Don't worry, I'm just beefing. Oh, it is working. Maybe I need to speak louder. Can you guys hear me, please? Yeah, I think so. Welcome back. Our next session is one that is very interesting. I think everyone, I need to speak up. What did you say? Right.
There we are.
Right. Guys, where was I? I was going to introduce our next session. This is a very interesting one. In fact, it was one of my favorite from Radio Days Europe last year in Prague. And I think I can also validate that with the number of people who have just walked into the room. Without further ado, I present to you Niall Power from Bit FM 102.103 over there in Ireland, and he will be presenting radio's top 10 promotions. Please give it up for Niall.
We okay? 1, 2, 1, 2. You can hear all right? Okay, it's great to be back with you guys. I have been doing this session since 2018 in Vienna, and I always start at this point when I'm thinking about the promotions I'm going to include. Kind of same every year, but the one that's changed a lot over the years is the utilizing station platforms, because what we'll see this year is more and more so a lot of content now going on social and web with the audio almost complementing it on air. So we're going to start, number one is in the Netherlands and a brilliant station called Q Music, which is a music station aimed at young adults. And I like this because it's a good old-fashioned time spent listening promotion. It's called The Forbidden Word, and this is the setup. Sound.
This is how it works. The Q Music DJs are not allowed to use a word chosen by the listeners for one entire week. That forbidden word is maybe. Listen to Q Music and pay attention. Do you hear the DJs say the forbidden word?
Spreek je misschien zo meteen?
Misschien heb jij er ervaring mee?
Nou, misschien is het ook...
Misschien wel zijn meest persoonlijke album tot nu toe.
Go to the Q Music app as quickly as you can. Click on the forbidden word at the bottom of the menu and press the big red button. One person is randomly selected from all button pushers. Are you on air? Then you win 500 euros. Easy money, right? We play the forbidden word all week, from Mattie and Marieke at 6 a.m. till the program of Joost Swinkels at 1 a.m. But watch out, the following moments do not count. You don't have to press the button when the forbidden word is used by a newsreader, guest or listener, if you hear it in commercials or if it's in song lyrics or imaging. But do you hear maybe outside of these moments? Then you have a chance to win 500 euros. So download the Q app now, listen to Q Music and catch the DJ using the forbidden word. Het verboden
woord. Now, the great thing about this is, of course, you can place those forbidden words wherever you want on your schedule. But if you've got a team on air that are very authentic, natural, chatting to each other, and you've got a very obvious word like maybe, well, you're going to need a big contingency budget.
Zij dacht, als ik nou nog even een goede laatste grap achterlaat, is het misschien straks gewoon kat in de zak.
Ja.
Sorry dat ik je me onderbreek, lieve Mariek.
Heb ik het nou al gezegd?
Oh. Ja, ik dacht het al te horen.
Ik merk helemaal aan mezelf dat ik ook niks meer durf te zeggen.
Ja, we zijn 7 minuten onderweg met de T-Pel. Ja, je mag dus gaan drukken in de Q-Music app op de rode knop. Dan bellen we je misschien zo direct terug.
Oh, je zei het ook.
Oh, nee. Er lag overal wat. Misschien... Ah! Zie je, ik zei net, ik jinx het misschien. Nu zeg ik het nog een keer.
Ik kan me voorstellen dat jij geen idee hebt wat het verboden woord eigenlijk is. Misschien...
Oh,
wat erg. En weet je wat het allerergste is? De hele fucking tekst had hij uitgegeven.
En daardoor is het misschien een beetje een hype geworden of zo.
Oh, daar ga je! Oh, nee!
Jij zat erop te wachten.
Is de kans misschien...
Oh, nee!
20, misschien...
Nee. Oké, misschien ook nog.
Nee! Ja, je zei het! Kut!
Je zei misschien... Okay, dit komt zo wel. Zei jij het nou ook? Iemand gaat 500 euro winnen. Misschien ben jij het wel.
Hey.
Oh, fucking hell. Fucking hell. Dat je misschien...
Oh, nee! Oh, fuck. Kak.
Loopt hij ineens een deur uit? Ik heb misschien ook veel filmische...
Ja, nou, laat maar.
Doe even door met het nieuws snel.
Ja, gewoon door met het nieuws.
En in het tempo waarin David hits aflevert, zou hij misschien voor het einde van het jaar nog het record voor meeste top 10 hits op zijn naam kunnen zetten. Zielsgelukkig dat deze week erop zit. Het is klaar. Het is klaar. Geen verboden woord meer.
Het verboden woord.
So what's great there is they used all the team. It wasn't just about breakfast and drive, which brings me to the next promotion to BBC Radio 1 in the United Kingdom. And similarly, this was a great opportunity to show off the entire lineup and drive it through breakfast. So they brought us the Radio 1 drop, a special promotion for Halloween. 11 Radio 1 presenters, a scared Jordan North and a revengeful Greg James. And one of the presenters has a button that controls the drop, but who can he trust and who will betray him? Here's the setup.
Oh, hello. I've been expecting you. This is the Radio 1 drop. Let the games begin. It's time for revenge, Jordan North. Let me take you back where Jordan North tricked me into thinking that I was going on holiday. But instead, I was trapped in a camper van for 62 hours. I had to work out the password to try and get myself out of there. Well, Mr. North, revenge never tasted so slimefully good. Jordan is currently in a secret location, dangling above a gunge tank. And here in the studio, we have 11 Radio 1 presenters ready to lie, trick, and deceive him. Or maybe they want to treat. The aim is for Team Trick to convince Jordan that they're safe and that behind their button's a lovely treat. But who will Jordan trust to stop himself from getting gunged?
Morning, Greg. Did you want a coffee?
Sorry. Can you... I'm trying to be evil. I don't...
Oh, sorry. I didn't realise.
Yes, I want a black coffee, please. Oh, a small bit of oat milk. Oat milk.
Right. Oat milk.
What's great as well, as you can see, this was a follow-on storyline from a previous event promotion they had, and this was the big finale.
I'm going to go for Sean O'Leary.
Okay.
I can't do this.
Sean O'Leary, please make your way to the podium and plug in your button. It's time.
I can't do this!
Jordan, thank you for trusting me. Trick, treat, or drop. I'm pushing my button now.
Prepare yourself.
Prepare yourself.
For the drop.
No! No!
I told you!
It's happening! Yes!
No!
Here we go!
Incredible.
And of course, you can catch Greg talking about more of those big events later here today at around 5 o'clock. We're going to go to Finland next and to a really creative radio station called Radio Rock. So the two hosts of their breakfast programme both turned 50 last year, and they decided to celebrate that with a tour around the country that was a 100-hour tour, their ages combined. Listeners could suggest the places where they went. And, you know, one of the important things that we're trying to do at our radio station in Ireland this year is just get out more and shake more hands and meet listeners. And so they went right across Finland, and the trip lasted 100 hours with a live broadcast every day for the 100 hours, live from the bus.
Mä haluaisin
esitellä teille nämä upeat miehet. He ovat täyttäneet 50. Harri täytti jo. Tääkin täyttää ihan just. Ja sen kunniaksi me ollaan kuulkaa tällä reissulla.
Oikein hyvää huomenta, tämä on Radio Rockia Korporaatio.
Ruotsis väriä 200 metriä.
Ui.
100 meter.
Joo, hyvin mielellään.
Meillä nimittäin soi aina Radio Rock sekä autossa että kotona. Niin sen takia halusin nähdä tämän porukan nyt täällä. This way, people!
Cucumber.
Leivi.
Siis on little run over.
Radio Rock.
So you can see the huge increase in market share. The renowned radio consultant Phil Dowse once said to me as a morning presenter that every hand you shake is a loyal listener because they feel that they've met you and they know you, and you saw the results there. We're going to go to Sydney in Australia next. I don't need to say too much to set this one up other than there are no rules, no codes, no regulations when it comes to Kyle and Jackie.
Uh-oh, what's that giant cock doing hanging out?
Intern Pete is out at Liverpool. Where someone will ride our big brown cock.
I want to ride that cock!
Every 5 seconds, they get $1,000.
Chase it off to a very smooth start. Holding position perfectly, Kyle and Jackie. Takes a little bit of sticks out. We're going to make it up to $2,000.
$2,000.
We've got two things
hanging on the
arm. He's off already.
That's nice. The ultimate sports socks. You want a good sock? Underworks. The number one's a dead under for socks.
And of course, if you're going to do something like this, you need to get your main personality involved and humiliate them as well.
Where is this giant cock? Where is the bastard? Guys, you don't have to cheer every time I walk past.
There it is.
Watch out. There's the chicken. Move. Excuse me, celebrity's coming. Yeah, what? Oh, one cock was standing there like, oh, I'm not moving. I thought, shit.
Sure, he's wearing the right outfit, Brooklyn.
How do I even get on here?
He's in a full suit. Look, he can't even get up on it. Go,
shut
Kyle.
Up, Jackie! Shut up, Jackie.
What are you gonna do, bro? You get on your hands and knees.
Oh yeah, he's using someone as a human step.
Go!
Yeah, Kyle! Okay. Oh!
Okay. Yeah. Right,
on the cock. Okay, here we go. Let's count it down. He's pretty solid at this point. He's got a strategy of leaning right back.
Down.
You might have needed that helmet after all.
That's not easy being as easy. I just don't feel. I feel for all women.
Yeah, that's right. Being where you? Top,
that's not cool. That's not fun. Thanks for coming, everyone.
All right, guys. Coming up next, Big Fat Time. You want Guy Sebastian double passes to his concert?
Never have done that.
Okay, let's go to something a bit more wholesome, I think. I'm going to take to my own radio station, Beat in Ireland, which is Ireland's first regional radio station, and we're targeting 15 to 34-year-olds across the southeast. And this is a very small idea that came to us last year that we're going to make even bigger this year. And it started with my morning co-host, Shona, who announced she'd never slept in a tent. So very quickly, we turned this around and created our own little mini festival. We kept the numbers small in year one, and we're bringing it back next month and going to make it bigger. You could win tickets to camp alongside us on our breakfast show. little bit nerve-wracking as to who might be sleeping in a tent beside us. But we were amazed at the response from people who actually wanted to do this, and we brought on board TikTokers, bands, celebrity chef, clients were jumping to get on board, and this is what happened for the Beat Breakfast campout. Let's go!
Morning time.
Good morning.
For the breakfast show, the morning show was wake up with your mates, so this was a really great way to do that. Although there are some people who say never eat food that listeners sent in. I don't know what they'd say about sleeping in a tent alongside them. We'll move on next to number six, and it's Germany next, Hit Radio FFH. And the guys brought the lie detector, which I remember the lie detector was very popular 15 or 20 years ago. We haven't seen so much of it since, but now that we've such power with our socials, with video content and with the web, it actually is a really, really clever idea to bring back. And it was quite simple. They wanted a promotion where there was great content on air and online. Also, they brought in the expert who, a bit like the guy in Meet the Parents, could really tell if people were telling lies. And they asked some very difficult questions, such as, have you cheated on your partner? Do you think you do a better job than your boss? Have you always paid your taxes? That kind of thing. And the contestants had the chance to win a lot of money. And the video I'm going to show you is a really powerful moment from that campaign where a wife had thought for 19 years that her husband had cheated on her. And she never believed him when he said every time that he didn't. And this is what happened when they put him through the test.
Haben Sie vor 19 Jahren Ihre jetzige Frau mit einer anderen Frau sexuell betrogen?
Ich sage seit 20 Jahren, seitdem das war, ich habe nichts gemacht. Und sie glaubt mir es nicht.
Sag einfach die Wahrheit. Das ist alles, was ich ihm sagen kann. Sag die Wahrheit, darum geht's.
Ich habe hier Christian aus Roggenberg sitzen und es geht jetzt für ihn um 10.000 Euro.
Der Test startet... Jetzt.
Ist Ihr Vorname Christian?
Ja.
Werden Sie mir im Test die Wahrheit sagen?
Ja.
Haben Sie in Ihrer Zeit als Lkw-Fahrer jemals einen Porno in der Fahrerkabine geguckt?
Nein.
Sind Sie der Typ Mann, welcher Freunde und Verwandte oft anlügt?
Nein.
Haben Sie schon mal gelogen, um sich vor einer Familienverpflichtung zu drücken?
Ja.
Waren Sie nach dem Kennenlernen Ihrer Frau noch auf Datingportalen unterwegs?
Nein.
Lügen oder betrügen Sie irgendwelche Behörden zu Ihrem Vorteil?
Nein.
Und haben Sie vor 19 Jahren Ihre jetzige Frau mit einer anderen Frau sexuell betrogen?
Nein.
Die Antworten werden analysiert.
Christian, zur Auswertung. Sie haben alle Fragen wahrheitsgemäß beantwortet und deshalb gewinnen Sie gerade 10.000 Euro.
Also nach der Geburt meiner Kinder ist das das Zweitschönste. Ja, meine Mutter hat immer zu mir gesagt, ehrlich währt am längsten. Ich bin ehrlich. Und warum soll ich damals meine Frau betrügen, wenn die unser Kind im Bauch hat? Warum?
Ich hab's dir seit 20 Jahren gesagt, dass ich nichts gemacht habe. Alles gut.
Alles gut.
Jetzt ist das aus der Welt. Endlich.
Erleichtert.
€10.000 für die Wahrheit. Der FFH-Lügendetektor.
Oui. Well done, Al. I don't know if she was more happy about the $10,000 or the truth, but anyway, good results. We're going to go back to Ireland now, to 98FM, a really big Dublin radio station, and this is another Halloween promotion, and again, a great example of bringing all the team on board. So often that we tend to focus on breakfast and drive for our promotions, but if you get a chance to introduce the rest of your team, that's a good thing and a win for the station. So on October 25th, the presenters were told that one of them would be murdered. And over 9 days, listeners had to listen in to collect clues. Did the presenter say something strange, or did they play a song with unusual lyrics? And on Halloween, the presenter, Suzanne Kane, was electrocuted by a dodgy microphone. She was murdered. An interrogation was hosted of all the presenters that ran on socials to find out who it was, and murder update bulletins ran across the station on air. And the killer was revealed the following morning and the winners announced. And this is just a little sample of the social content.
This Halloween, one presenter will be murdered.
Did you kill Suzanne to take full control of the show?
I would never kill Suzanne. Suzanne is my friend.
Three people of Dublin want to know about your jobs. Like, what kind of jobs do you do? What about
your... Oh, you've got something.
I got it. Sorted. I've got your back.
What is your relationship with one Suzanne Kane?
I suppose, friend.
Were you annoyed? Did you want revenge for her messing up your show?
Could have been mildly irritated, perhaps.
Spotted you had popped two butter knives into your bag. Do you always carry knives in your bag, Rebecca?
I just want some toast after the show. I was hungry.
Get ready for 98FM's Dead Air.
So, going back to my first page, it's always important to grab those moments like Halloween and take the opportunity to do something a little bit different. And that leads me to our next promotion, which is Absolute Radio in the UK. And a couple of weeks back, of course, we had a leap day, a bonus day, so to speak, an extra day. And we did a similar promotion ourselves at Beat, where we asked our listeners what would they do if, you know, money was pretty much no limit on a bonus day. It's very interesting to hear what listeners come up with. And Bush and Richie is the drive time show on Absolute Radio. So they offered this, and I can tell you the answer was quite unusual. A man wanted to go down and see the underground.
Our bonus day is here. It is that leap year extra day in February, and we're about to make listener Ray's dream come true.
Ray, you wanted to go underground?
I did, yeah.
So here we are in Mayfair, one of the disused London underground stations. We're going to go on a hidden London tour thanks to the London Transport Museum. Let's go.
Hi everyone, welcome. This is Down Street, and we're going to have a bit of a look around today, and we're going to see some of the original features, and then we've got the rich tapestry of wartime history to delve into and explore as well.
When was the last time it was dusted?
A long time ago.
We've come deeper and deeper into the darkness of the tunnels. Paul, where are we right now? What's going on?
Yeah, so we've now come down onto literal platform level. In a moment, we'll probably see some Piccadilly line trains literally whizzing past us. So here's one.
Is there any chance of ghosts down here? Do you think it's haunted?
I mean, they came down here, did their stuff, and then left.
Another breeze.
So you can start.
It's a message.
It.
It's a message.
Come through
there
now. Yes.
See, you do like trains.
It's all right, isn't it?
What do you reckon, Ray?
Oh, yeah, I'm loving it.
After making our way out of those haunted tunnels, we took Ray for a burger at the Hard Rock Cafe. I'm not sure if Richie and Ray got locked in the vault, but I seem to lose them on the way back to the studio. Where are they?
I've actually got my eyes on the little Mochetti things.
Yeah. Right, here we go.
Are these draft excluders? That's amazing.
Definitely a draft excluder.
They're fantastic. I reckon I could get away with that.
Do you do any cooking, Richie?
Oh, I can't wait
these posters.
That would look well good by the front door.
This is the book, Richie.
Downstreet,
yeah. That's the one, yeah.
So sometimes we think if we want to make a listener's dreams come true, we need to give them cash or holidays, but sometimes they just want to go underground. And having arrived in late last night, I can confirm the S-Bahn and the U-Bahn are a lot more pleasant and clean here in Munich than what we saw in that video. We're going to go to South Africa next, to KFM 94.5 in Cape Town. And I know we have a lot of nationalities here. I don't know if The Masked Singer is popular in your market on TV. It's a very popular format in the UK and Ireland and in other countries. And KFM decided to ask if they could recreate that on the radio. And they did a really good job of it because it was the winner of the Innovation Award at the South African Radio Awards in 2023. So they picked four non-singing celebrities in their market, put them into a studio with a renowned producer to record their favourite song. And then listeners heard the singer, one singer each week. They had some audio and visual clues on social to work out who that celebrity was. And each week, one of the listeners who correctly identified the celebrity was rewarded with a cash prize and an experience. And this is how it went.
Guess who is behind that voice? The KFM Mystery Mike with Carl Wastey on KFM 94.5.
Stand by to hear the celebs you love in a way you've never heard them before. In this studio, where you'll have to identify who they are based only on their singing voice.
Got this feeling down deep in my soul and I just can't lose. Guess I'm on my way.
It's me, JP Dumney. You know, you think of when you're singing in the shower, you know, you think you're pretty good. And that was always me.
I've become used to JP Dumney's performing under pressure. I've enjoyed watching him playing cricket. This, I think, was one of his best performances.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence.
Hi guys, you guessed it. Or you didn't guess it. It's Nick Rabinowitz, comedian and part-time shower singer. I feel a bit embarrassed about some of the notes I hit. I feel like my wife's gonna laugh, to be honest. She heard me practicing last night and she just thought it was so hilarious.
I think I'd definitely invite him back to the booth. He brought an energy that we don't often get in the studio.
Right, I'll be the perfect wife, buying groceries, buy what you need.
You got the 9 to 5, but baby, okay, let me see. Oh, hi.
Hi, I'm Zola Nene, I'm a chef and an award-winning cookbook author and a lover of all things food. Food is my love language, and apparently singing is becoming one of my new ones.
To be honest, you never know what you're gonna get. When someone who isn't a singer walks into the studio, she absolutely killed it, made my job super easy.
Ah, you made it sound so good!
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
Hey everyone, I am Jordan Hill-Lewis, the mayor of Cape Town, and hopefully Disney's new up-and-coming star. All right, let's do it. I was terrified because I'm not a great singer. I was fired from the primary school choir.
Working with the mayor was super cool. I kept calling him sir, he didn't like that.
Guess I'm on my way. So you gave me the opportunity now to pursue a certain passion.
After this experience, listening to yourself, listening to the finished product, would you release a song?
No.
I'm working on my first album now. It should be ready for Christmas.
Just call me a singer now. Forget the chef title, a singer.
The KFM Mystery Mike with Carl Wastey on KFM 94.5.
So I think that's a really great idea. It doesn't matter the size of your market, you could make that one work. Right, we're on to our last one. We're back to Australia, this time to Melbourne, and a guy who has spoken at Radio Days a couple of times, a really talented guy, Christian O'Connell, who's on Gold 104.3. And they've run this promotion a couple of times now, 48 hours of. And it's quite simple. They bring a load of listeners, put them in a cinema to watch the same movie over and over and over and over and over. And the last person who doesn't fall asleep, basically, will win cash. And so the perfect movie last year when they did it, Groundhog Day, and if they lasted the full 48 hours, they would have watched it up to 29 times. Here's how it went.
Christian O'Connell's 48-hour movie marathon. 15 contestants, no sleeping, no caffeine. Groundhog Day on repeat for 48 hours.
Groundhog Day.
Monday, 7:45 a.m. Everybody is pumped for the start.
3, 2, 1.
Play it, Rio.
7 hours in. First sign of trouble from young Scorsese.
I think I'll be out in the next movie, I think.
He did amazingly, but he was the first to go.
I've left at 15 hours, and I made it through 10 watchings.
Yogi was the next to fall.
I left 16 and a half hours.
23 hours. PC Tony couldn't resist the tasty dangling carrot.
If anyone would like to leave the cinema right now, you'll take home a two-night stay at the lovely Como Hotel. PC Tony, come down. He's going to ring the bell.
Oh! My wife would kill me if I didn't take that.
Halfway there.
Guys, you've all passed the 24-hour mark.
Didn't matter. A restaurant voucher was enough for Blank Slate to tap out.
Yeah, I think it's good enough for me.
Congratulations.
Wreck-It Ralph broke a rib last week, but it's helping her.
If I stretch the right way, it does hurt, so it wakes me up a little bit. So it's a little strategy that I have been using.
Sleeping Beauty's wife called in.
He's done very well. I'm actually quite shocked.
If I had heard from my daughter, I think I would have started crying.
This is... Bye, Daddy!
Oh, you're doing so well in there, buddy.
24 hours to go. That's it.
Spoken like a true wife. You know, it's breaking down in tears.
30 hours. The insomniac is going strong.
Me being insomniac is proving true. I'm definitely staying wide awake compared to the others that I see dozing off.
36 hours. The nurse. You did amazing. But sayonara.
I left after 21 hours.
Nope, you're delirious. It was 36 hours. 1 a.m. Julie Andrews had enough and didn't even say goodbye. 2 a.m. Woodchuck Steve got snoozy.
I was there. I was in the zone. The next minute, I was getting woken up.
After a very short 48 hours, they got to the finish line.
3, 2, 1, it's over.
Jack, send the families in. Send the families in, Jack. Go on in. Go, go, go. Empty water bottles are currently being thrown in the air. Contestants who were rivals are high-fiving each other. Families are running in. I'm getting cheered up here. It's beautiful.
You're free to go.
Woo! Freedom awaits you. Freedom, everyone. Well done. The final eight.
So I was quite amazed at how many were left at the end as someone who likes to nap every 3 hours like a cat. So, finally, our takeaways. Always the key points. Ensure your mechanic's not overly complicated. Give it the serial effect so that people want to know what happens next and they stick with you. Ensure that 360 approach so that you've got a lot of content. There was a great talk here earlier at the promotion deep dive about make sure your content is across all the networks. But always bring it back to on air because at the end of the day, we are radio people. Your big budgets aren't everything. Sometimes those small ideas really, really effective. And it's all about being creative. And I leave you with this quote, which I always like from Derek, who's the group content director in KISS. The greatest radio promotions should be explained and understood in the title alone. The build and the hype is everything. Thank you very much, guys.
I don't mind. Do you have time?
Yes. Hey, guys. Guys, for everyone going out, if you have any questions, Niall actually has 6 more minutes. So if you're happy to share questions, he's happy to answer them. No? Yes? Looks like you're free to go. See you at 2, guys.